What's up, guys? Firelord here with another video, where today we are going to be finishing up our Shadow Trooper build. So, in the last part, we got all of this torso area... Well, not torso, this torso. We got all of this leg area here. So, in this final part, I'm going to be putting on the arms, and then, by the reveiw, I will have had put the stickers on, which would be very... wouldn't be very entertaining to watch, so we're not going to do that on camera. So, basically, I'm going to do a review of this. It's not the building, I'm just going to review the figure, the accessories, posability, etc. Pretty normal. So, let me know if you like this video, if you want me to do another one of these where I build it in the camera, or would you prefer if I just did the reviews of the figure and build it on my own time? Let me know. So, anyway, getting out the instructions, you will see, you last left off on this step right here. So, now we are going to do the arm right here. Okay. So, first thing I'm going to need is going to be, I need A55 and B3. Okay. So, let me get out the A sheet. 55. Alright, A50. Oh shoot, bumped my light. Okay. A55 is right here. Alright. And then B3. Oh shoot, dropped one of the sheets. Okay, got that. Alright, B3. Alright, it's right there. So now I'm going to take these two pieces, they will go together just like that. Okay, so... Alright, so this is just going to slide right in there. Oh, goodness. That's tedious. Ooh. Just slots into place like that. Damn. Something stuck in my throat. Sorry for that. Let me just snip off some of the excess there. Alright. So I just put that piece into there. Alright. So, next I am going to need... A48, that's one of them. Okay. Alright, A48. That thing is annoying, whatever is in my throat. Have this piece. Going to need A49. Should just be right next to it. Oh. Okay, so got that. And then I need piece 10. Piece 10. Right here. Okay. Oh, and don't forget to check out the other two parts if you haven't already, so then you'll know where we are right now. I will leave a link down in the description below. Okay. So now, piece to my camera keeps cutting out for no apparent reason at all. But anyway, as I was stating, gotta readjust my camera focus. Alright, so piece 10 is going to go like this. And then I'm going to take A48. It's going to go in there. I'm guessing this is going to form like the elbow joint. And then this is just going tab right in to there. Okay. We've got that. And then, alright, basically, this will just clip into here. There's a little clip on piece 10 that will connect into this little slot right there. So, not elbow joint, but joint nonetheless. Okay, so that will just tab right in to... I think I got it. Alright. So, there is that. Okay. So, next up on our instructions is A50, piece 13, and then two piece 13s. So, A50. Alright. A50 is right there. Alright, and then two piece 13s. Right, and lastly, A51. Wait, A50, no. No, A51, yeah. Okay. Alright. So, now I have all the pieces that I need. So, A51's going to go just like this. Then the two 13s are going to go right there. Right there. I'm guessing this is going to form the elbow joint. And then A50 is just going to go right in there. Okay. Nice. So that aside. Now I need B2, B14. B2, B14. Okay, so I've got those two pieces, so now I need piece 14. Okay, right, so let's put them together now. So, according to the instructions, this is just... Right, hold on. Okay, I see. So, just like on the legs, this piece is gonna slide right into there. Again, gotta do this off camera. Alright, so that piece just slides in there, and then this piece is going to slide right in there. Okay, so now we have this piece already. So, next up on the to-do list, I need B27 and 26. Wait, is that right? 27, 26, okay. Alright, these two pieces right here. Snip, 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 snip. Alright, so I've got that, and then I'm going to need piece 15. Alright. Right, and then this is just going to go right in to there, and then this piece is going to go on top of that. Those will just snap right on together. Okay, so now I have to assemble these three pieces. So, this piece goes like that, then this piece, making sure this little pointy bit is up, slide right into there. Right? Snaps into place a lot better than the legs. Right? So, and then this piece is going to go, so if this piece is facing like that, then I guess this one will snap in. Hard to see in the instructions, I can't tell. Alright, I think this goes right in to here. That. That'll just snap into place. Okay. And there we have that. So, next up, I need to cut out a hand. Still don't know how right this arm is. Yeah, actually, this seems right enough. If not, I'll be able to tell once we assemble it. Okay, so anyway, now I need a hand. I need A29 and B20. So, A29 is what right here. I will be using the interchangeable hands in the reveiw, but for building purposes, just going to use that one. And then B20. Which is right here. Snip that out. Alright, so now that's cut out, and this will just snap right in to there. The shoulder pad can move out of the way so you can accommodate movement, or it will just snap off, of course. Again, this model isn't really for playing as much as it is displaying, so, I mean, pieces should pop off, but once you have it in the pose you like, should be fine. Okay. And then I'm going to, so that's popped in there. Just going to slide in the hand, and then the little hand piece, hand armor. Okay. And there you have an arm all done. So now I am going to build the other arm. So I finished with the second arm, so now we have two arms. So now let's just attach them onto the Shadow Trooper, and just snaps in to the ball joint there. And there you go. There is the Shadow Trooper completely finished, basically. We still have to do the guns and the display base, so. There we raise up. There's the Shadow Trooper. Oh, and the stickers, forgot this. So, yeah. I would say this was pretty cool. So now, let us just get started on the weapons and display base. So, I'm going to start with the pistol, which should be fairly easy. Okay. And again, I will go over all of the extra accessories in my full review. So, snip that. Focus. And now there is a little tiny nub at the end there that you should not snip. So, I'll snip just below that. Actually, let me try pulling it off. Yep, it just comes right off. So, this little nub right here at the end, do not pull that off. So, now I'm going to need a 36. Alright, very tiny piece right there. Alright, got those. So now that will tediously just slide right into the end there, completing the pistol. That's correct? Yes, that's correct. So, blaster pistol right there. So next is the E11. So. Might I add that there is great molded detail on these guns. Like, oh shoot, didn't mean to do that. Okay, but just look at this detail on this E11. I do wish this little section could fold out, but I mean, it doesn't have to. Alright, and now this is going to be a few pieces. A33. Alright, this tiny piece right here. Okay. So A33 is just going to plug into the end there. Just like this. Okay, so that's just going to plug into the end there. Then A43 and 42. So, they're just right next to each other, right there. Oh, shoot. Oh, wait, never mind. Okay, that flew off, but I see it. Alright. Be careful in cutting these tiny pieces out. They could go flying, as mine just did. Fortunately, I was able to find it with relative ease. So, now I need a 42, which is right there, even smaller. Okay, so I got these two tiny pieces. So, this piece, wait, where, okay, there's the E11. Alright, so, this piece right here is just going to plug in to the top here. Yes. So it's just going to plug in right here on the scope. I guess you don't have to have that. That could just be an optional piece. So it looks perfectly fine without it. Don't know if it's accurate or not, but I'll check after this. And then A42 just goes into the end right there to make the ammo clip. No, magazine. Yeah, that's the mag. Alright, so there's the E11. So now the blaster carbine, I believe. I know the names, I just forgot them, so I'll have to remember them for the review. But it's this long blaster, like the ones that the heavies use in Battlefront. Okay, so those pegs need to be on there. That's difficult. That didn't turn out well now, did it? Okay. Right. So now I need a 30, which is the other half of the blaster. And while I'm at it, I'll just cut out a 32 as well, which will make the bipod, but can't actually flip out, just for display purposes to make it accurate. Right, and then last, well, I need A34, which is a tiny peg. Right. And then A35. And we can begin assembling. So, based on what I'm seeing here, this will just plug in here, will tab in. I keep saying plug in when I mean tab in. So that's gonna tab right in there. And then this little peg is going to go through right there, I believe. It's gonna make up a little handle. Oh, that's difficult. Okay. Oh, shoot. Alright. So that's just going to plug in right there. And then I'm going to take this end nozzle here, plug that in, and then take the bipod and just plug that in to here. And there you have the heavy gun. Alright, so there's all that. Holstering. Alright, and lastly, we are going to cut out the display base. So there are a few pieces to that. There's this little section right here, which is where you'll place the foot if you want it to be a bit more secure. And then you have this connector piece. So I'm not 100% sure about this because I don't have any other ones, but my guess is if you get some other Star Wars build kits, you can actually connect the display bases so you can make one big display, which I might do. I mean, this is a pretty neat display base. I mean, it's simple. Okay, so let's pop the display base on out, and then this little piece can either sit flush to the ground like so, you can't really see it, or you can flip it out and then have the foot wherever you want. And until the review, I'm probably just gonna keep it like this. Alright. And then, this piece, yeah, it can plug them, so just plugs into the bottom there. Alright, and if you happen to have the BA4A connector action base, you can use that for display, but I don't have of that. So, this is the Shadow Trooper. So, you have all of this is what I had to build. So, I will talk more about this on the review, but little basics. I enjoyed building this a lot. This was a whole lot of fun to build. I'll polish it up off to get rid of some of those fingerprints there. But I would definitely recommend one of these kits to anyone who's good at building. Gotta have small fingers because there's very tedious work in the blasters, but all in all, I do like this quite a lot. So I think that's going to wrap up our video. Please like and subscribe. That would be extremely nice. Hope you all have an awesome day. This is Fire Lord out.